happened to me with my mother. Every time I go home, I just realize that I'm Hungarian anyway, and the Hungarian people are more into others' lives and others' habits. And while we were driving to somewhere, she keeps repeating, "Why is this car? This color is terrible. Why is this? That? Why is this?" You know, we and for I don't know for an hour, I'm okay. Well, she's like this. She's judging, and then after I think an hour, I'm like, shall I say that? Don't judge. That I'm judging her, of course, while I, you know. But how you get over in these situations? Sure, you try to walk away. I mean, I can't walk away from having a car with someone. But in these situations, I try to accept things. But after a while, I realize that I don't. I mean, I accept for a while, but then I don't. So what are the solutions in these cases?
You see, judging that you are talking of is an action. No action is right or wrong. All that matters is the center from where the action is arising. Here, especially in the West, you have this notion, don't judge. It's not quite correct. Judging is an action like any other action. It's not important to not to judge. It's important to not to judge from the wrong center. From the right center, if you can say that this person is afraid and that will be harmful for himself, you have judged. But this is a very useful and auspicious judgment. But let's say if you have your own needs for appreciation, then you will compare yourself to others and judge them. Let's say one is not rich enough in her own imagination. So she looks at rich people and says, you know, murderers. I know how they have collected their wealth. Now, in fact, she might be factually right. The one she is pointing towards may actually be a murderer and might have actually collected his wealth through loot. But the comparison is coming from the wrong center. She is saying all this only because she wants to feel superior. So this judgment is from the wrong center. Hence this judgment should not be made even if it is factually correct. Factually what she has just said may be right. But facts don't matter. What matters is life. And in life, what matters is the place you are operating from. If you are operating from the conditioned mind, the ego, then you will only get suffering. Even if you are speaking the facts. You getting it? So judge. But judge from a center of compassion, of love, of integrity. If judging someone is wrong, then all the judges in the courts must go to hell. Obviously, it cannot be wrong. But it is surely wrong when you judge just to uphold your own feeble ego. And don't we often do that? We judge others so that we can feel superior in comparison to them. We judge others so that our own evils appear smaller in comparison to them. Then such judgments are indeed evil. Yes? But you look at even the lives of the saints and the prophets, they have often very clearly declared the wrong to be wrong, which is in today's parlance a clear case of being judgmental. They were very judgmental, but they were judgmental because they were compassionate. Such judgments are all right. Was not Christ judgmental? Look at his utterances and you will see, oh? Several of the things that he said, if you say, people will say, you are judging. Was not a Kabir judgmental? But you get the right to judge others only after you have first judged yourself rightly. And that requires honesty. When you know yourself, then you also get the right to know others and also declare what you know. Only then. Before you look at others, before you try to measure them, firstly look at yourself and see who you are. Alright?